Hi guys, in this video, I'm gonna talk about TSNE and show an example using scikit-learn. First, let's take a look at what TSNE is. High dimension datasets can be very difficult to visualize, right? You can use TSNE to visualize complex datasets in 2 or 3 dimensions. TSNE is a nonlinear dimensionality reduction technique for visualizing high dimensional data. So, how does TSNE do that? Let me explain. TSNE projects each high dimensional point into a 2 or 3 dimensional space. To do this, similar points are modeled close to each other and these similar points are modeled farther away. For example, you see a data in 3 dimensional space on the screen. For this data, you can't use linear dimensional reduction technique. When you visualize this data with TSNE, you can get such a graph. Okay, after defining briefly TSNE, let me show an example using scikit-learn. To do this, first, I am gonna load the digit dataset using scikit-learn. Let me import load digits from sklearn.dataset import load digits. Now, using this method, let's load the digit dataset. Digits equals load digits. Cool! Our dataset loaded. Let's take a look at the shape of the dataset. Digits.data.shape. The digit data attribute lets us access a tabular version of this dataset. As you can see, the dataset consists of images and each data point is an 8x8 image of a digit. Let me show the first image in the dataset. To do this, I'm gonna use matplotlib. Let's import this library. Import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Let's have a look at the first digit. plt.matshow. Digits.images 0. As you can see, the first image is 0. Next, let's create the input and output variables. Y digits equals digits.target. X digits equals digits.data. So, I assigned the features to X digits and the labels to Y digits. Note that the digit dataset consists of 64 dimensional. We want to project this 64 dimensional dataset onto a 2 dimensional space. To do this, let's use TSNE. First, let me import TSNE class from sklearn.manifold import TSNE. Now, let me get an example from this class. TSNE equals TSNE to reduce a 2 dimensional. Let me set n components equal 2. To initialize the TSNE embedding, let me set init equal PCA. For learning rate, let me set auto. Lastly, for reproducible results, let me write random state 1, 2, 3. Beautiful! We created an object from TSNE class. Now, let's fit and transform this object into our dataset. X digits. TSNE equals TSNE dot fit transform. Let me set x digits. So we projected our dataset onto a 2-dimensional space. Cool. Now let's visualize 2D TSNE embedding. First, let me import NumPy. Import NumPy as np. Now let's create a graph object. F equals plt dot figure fix size. Let's say 8,8. Let me subplot method. Ax equals plt dot subplot. For aspect argument, let me set equal. Now I'm gonna plot the scatter for digits. To do this, let me use for loop. For e in range 10. Let's use scatter method. Plt scatter. First, let me set x digits TSNE square brackets y digits equal equal I comma 0 x digits TSNE y digits equal equal I 1. Now, let's take a look at this plot. Here you go. As you can see, the 2-dimensional scatter plot of TSNE is plotted. If you want, you can add digits on the plot. To do this, I am pasting the codes I prepared before. Let me paste these codes. Let me run these codes. Here you go. As you can see, TCNE is able to separate the different digits nicely, but not perfectly. If you want, you can obtain better separation by tuning the hyperparameters. So, we saw how to project the 64-dimensional dataset onto a 2-dimensional space. That's it. In summary, to visualize high-dimensional data, you can use TCNE technique. In this video, I talk about TCNE and showed how to visualize high-dimensional data with TCNE. You can find the link of this notebook in the description below. I hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, give me a like, and leave a comment. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye for now.